see, how are we doing on time? We have 8 minutes left, and then it's autograph time. So, you know what? I love you guys, but I would wager money that the people in the back of the room think I will never call on somebody in the back of the room, right? Too far away. You look awesome, by the way. You're way too tall. Whenever I see somebody that's like tall, dressed as Ed, I'm like, you should be like Dream Ed. Like, this is Ed in his dreams. Okay, let's see. Hi.
You.
Hi, what's your name? Haley? Say hi to Haley, everybody. Question, my dear.
What was the funniest thing you ever done as a voice actor?
The funniest thing I ever did as a voice actor? You mean like funniest character or like? Wow, funniest thing I ever did as a voice actor. Let me think, Kate. Well, I don't know if it's funny. Maybe funny to you. There was a show that I did while I was still living in Houston years ago called Princess Nine. Does anybody remember that show? It was about a girls' baseball team. It was such a great show. And I played this character named Hiroki Takasugi. And Hiroki was the captain of the boys' baseball team. And then he was in love with the girl who was the captain of the girls' baseball team. And of course, as you would expect, they meet in the championship to play each other, and they have to play each other, but they love each other. Drama. And so I loved that show so much, Haley. I loved Hiroki so much. And I had only done like maybe, I don't even know, like maybe 20 anime series by then. I've done 300 now. But at the time, it was early on, right? So I loved Hiroki so much that I literally went to a sporting goods store right down at 610 and I-10, I can still remember where it was. And I looked them up online because they made baseball uniforms. And I went to this store and I showed them pictures of Hiroki. And they made me a baseball jersey. I mean, with the embroidered kanji letters on the front and everything that looked just like his. And every time I went into the studio to record Princess Nine, I wore the baseball jersey. I don't know if that's funny, but it's weird. It's a little weird. But it is funny. It was funny for the director, because he made fun of me all the time for that. But okay, we probably have time for one more. Who was the, yes, you were the one that I said that I loved, but I went to the back of the room. So, what is your question?
How excited are you to be a Black Butler?
I just am excited to be a part of it. You know what? I'm going to tell you my Black Butler story.
Yeah.
When the first season came out and they were casting for Black Butler, I auditioned for it. And of course, they had an English accent, right? I sent my audition in. And at the time, Colleen Klinkenbeard was directing Black Butler. It wasn't... No, it wasn't Ian. I think Ian Sinclair directs Black Butler now. But at the beginning, it was Colleen. So I sent my audition into Colleen, and she wrote me back and she said, hey, loved your audition, but your accent sucks. Aww. Yeah, right, harsh. Yeah. But not a great person with accents, so what are you gonna do, right? So then season two came along, and Ian Sinclair sent me an audition for a character named Claude. Aww. Is he a good character?
Hello.
Well, thank God. I hope he's a stupid character. Because I auditioned for him. And you guys, I was like, I am going to nail this audition. My accent wasn't that great last time. I'm going to spend all the time I need. I'm going to send my audition to an English guy to test, make sure, right? Make sure I get it right. And I spent all this time, and I even played it for my British friends, and like, sounds great. It's wonderful. So I sent it off, and Ian wrote me back, and he's like, hey dude, got the audition, acting's great, your accent still sucks. So I was like, crap, I'm never gonna be a stupid Black Butler. So then, you know, then Book of Circus comes along. And apparently, the people in Book of Circus have Cockney accents. So it's bad enough that I can't do an English accent. But let's just, and it's just, you know, amp it up a little bit, make it harder. So I auditioned and I got to play Peter in the in Book of Circus. So I am very excited to just be any small part of it, because it's such a cool show and I know a lot of people enjoy it. So, you guys, it is that time. Hey, listen, you have fun this weekend, okay? I wasn't supposed to be here, like I said, but I'm so happy to be just for today. We're gonna set up a table. We're gonna set up a table here on stage, and I've got 2 hours, and I will get to as many people as I possibly can. So I'm gonna give the microphone to this lovely girl. This is Susan, and she's gonna tell you how she wants to organize this. And